Hello friends, welcome back to another episode of Engineering Today, and I hope you're all having a great time. In Starbase, there's a lot going on. SpaceX is getting ready for the fourth test flight of Starship. They've been busy stacking the rocket parts together. Just recently, they put Ship 29 on top of Booster 11. The process of stacking the Starship rocket is quite a sight to see. They used giant arms, chopsticks on the launch tower to carefully lift and place the parts together. Before stacking the parts together, SpaceX tested each part separately. They checked the Super Heavy and ship to make sure everything works as it should. And now, launch rehearsal for Flight 4 is complete. SpaceX Starship Integrated Flight Test 4, IFT-4, is getting closer, and it's now expected to take place in late May or early June, within the next 2 weeks. Booster 11 for Flight 4 is now at the launch site. Also, Ship 31 for Flight 5 is getting ready at Massey's. Though Ship 31 appears to have suffered an issue during its cryo testing at Massey's. There are three more boosters waiting inside the Mega Bay. Two of them have finished cryo-proof testing. They either have engines already or are about to get them. At the same time, Pad B demolition is happening. They're breaking it down to make space for another tower or pad. Before that, SpaceX did a static fire of Ship 30. This happened on May 8th at the Starbase site in South Texas. During this test, they briefly fired up all six of the Raptor engines on the upper stage of the rocket. After the static fire test, Ship 30 got connected to the two-point lifter. Then it was taken off Pad B and sent back to the production site. As planned, SpaceX is now taking down Pad B to make space for new developments. The demolition of Pad B is going full steam ahead, with SpaceX not wasting any time. They're clearing the area quickly to make room for the second orbital pad that's coming up. The Flight 4 rocket seems all set to go. However, there's still one more thing SpaceX needs to do before the launch. They need to get a launch license from the Federal Aviation Administration. This is because the FAA is still checking out what happened during Starship's last liftoff. SpaceX is getting closer to making its plans for a Starship launch site at Kennedy Space Center a reality. They're also eyeing taking over a launch site from the nearby Cape Canaveral Space Force Station. The FAA has started looking into the impact this could have on the environment. They're focusing on the Launch Complex 39A at Kennedy Space Center. SpaceX has already begun building a Starship launch tower there, next to their existing pad used for Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy launches. Work on this tower paused in late 2022, as SpaceX shifted its attention to developing the Starship and Super Heavy rocket at their test site in Texas. NASA leases LC-39A to SpaceX. Back in 2019, NASA did an assessment of the environmental impact of Starship launches under the National Environmental Policy Act. But since then, the rocket design has changed, and SpaceX has new launch plans. So NASA thinks a more thorough environmental impact statement is needed. This process could take up to 18 months to finish. SpaceX wants to launch rockets from Launch Complex 39A up to 44 times a year. That's a lot more than the previous plan of 24 launches. Meanwhile, the FAA wants to hear from the public too. They're going to have meetings where people can come and talk. There are two in-person meetings at Cape Canaveral and Kennedy Space Center, and there's one virtual meeting online. These meetings will happen in June. During this time, called the scoping period, people can give their opinions. They can talk about what they think about SpaceX's plans. This is important because it helps the FAA understand what people want. People can give their opinions until June 24th. Now, SpaceX has some new ideas. They want to add more launch infrastructure, build ponds for handling stormwater or emergencies, and use a newer version of the Starship Super Heavy rocket. On the other hand, SpaceX has revealed its brand new spacesuit designed for astronauts on the upcoming Polaris Dawn mission. This mission is part of the Polaris program, which aims to push the boundaries of human spaceflight and raise money for research on Earth, particularly cancer research. Jared Isaacman, the brains behind Polaris program, is not only a billionaire CEO, but also a skilled pilot and astronaut. He founded Draken International, a private air force training pilots for the U.S. Armed Forces. With Polaris, he's aiming high, hoping to advance spaceflight and tackle issues like cancer. The first mission of the Polaris program, Polaris Dawn, has been delayed a few times but is now set for a launch no earlier than this summer. It's a five-day journey with four crew members, aiming to study human health in space and on Earth. This mission marks the beginning of SpaceX's involvement in human spaceflight, beyond what they've already done with NASA and other commercial customers. The crew for Polaris Dawn includes some familiar faces from SpaceX, like Sarah Gillis and Anna Menon, who've been involved in previous Crew Dragon flights. Scott Poteet, a retired Air Force Lieutenant Colonel, and Jared Isaacman himself will also be on board. Isaacman previously led SpaceX's Inspiration 4 mission, which sent civilians to space for the first time. One of the most significant aspects of Polaris Dawn is the spacewalk planned during the mission. SpaceX has developed a new spacesuit for this purpose, which offers improved mobility and comfort for the astronauts. The Dragon capsule used for the mission has also been modified to support the spacewalk, with additional structures and systems in place to ensure the safety of the crew. In other news, Elon Musk doesn't buy into the idea that aliens have ever popped by for a visit to Earth. He shared his thoughts at the 2024 Milken Institute Global Conference in Los Angeles. Musk talked about how some people believe aliens are chilling among us, which he finds kind of funny. He mentioned how it's strange that these same people doubt whether we've ever been to the moon. The SpaceX boss explained why he's not sold on the idea of alien visitors. Despite SpaceX having a bunch of satellites zooming around in space, they've never come across any solid evidence of aliens or their spacecraft. He pointed out that with SpaceX's Starlink project, they've got thousands of satellites up there, and none of them have had to dodge any UFOs. But Musk isn't completely shutting the door on the possibility. He said he's open to changing his mind if someone brings forth some convincing evidence. He's just not seeing it right now. Then Musk brought up a big question. If there are alien civilizations out there, why haven't they explored the whole Milky Way galaxy by now? He thinks it's weird that we haven't seen any signs of them. He compared humanity to a tiny candle flickering in a vast dark room. He said we need to do everything we can to keep that candle burning. There was a little hiccup, though. Musk mentioned that Starlink satellites often have to dodge space junk or other satellites to avoid collisions. SpaceX reported that between June and November 2023, Starlink satellites did over 24,000 maneuvers to avoid potential crashes, like six moves per satellite. So while Musk isn't convinced about alien visitors, he's keeping an open mind. But for now, it's still a bit of a mystery whether we're alone in the universe. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.